Good morning, students. Today, study about a very famous historical event that is known as the first struggle for democracy, the French Revolution. The roots of democracy lie in this revolution. It was the first time when people think, they had a thought, they had a vision about the democracy. They had a plan that what can be done or what is to be done to get rid of the monarchy and establish a democratic rule in the country. Many things were happening there in France, but we start understanding all these things from the date 14 July 1789. Suddenly, on the morning of 14 July 1789, the city of Paris was said to be in the state of alarm. It means a lot of chaos was there in the city, and there was a rumor in the city that king has ordered his troops, his soldiers, to open fire on the citizens. About 7,000 men were gathered there in front of the town hall and decided to form people's militia to fight against the king. And that group, they attacked the bazaar, released the prisoners. There were only 7 prisoners in the bazaar. They released those. And it was mostly the symbolic. 7 prisoners were not a very big issue, but that was done symbolically because the Bastille was a fortress prison. There were a lot of ammunition there. The people, they want to get the ammunition as well as the head Bastille, because it was the symbol of the monarchy's rule in the country. So they want to destroy, they attacked Bastille, they attacked other government offices, they destroyed everything. And they were having hate that much that they sold the stones of the Bastille. They collected all the stones which were gathered there after destruction, and they sold to the people who want to keep it as memory. Why this much hate for the monarchical rule? Why they hate their king that much? This was the event which led eventually the killing of the king and the start of democratic rule in the country. But it does not happen in one day. It took a long time. There is a long history why all these things happen. So after listening the events of 14 July 1789, we should move and we should look back in the history, what were the reasons why people demonstrated to that much large extent. So now you see the situations, what are the situations there in France at that time. To understand French society, we need to go back to the year 1774. In the year 1774, Louis XVI from Bourbon family ascended the throne, became the king at the age of 20 years. He was just 20 years old when he became king, and he was married to Austrian princess, not Australian princess. Australia was not recognized as a country till that time. So Austrian princess, the name was Mary Antonia. Now that 20-year-old king, when he ascended the throne, what he got? He got an empty pressure. He had nothing with him. Why? Because of long wars. France was regularly with wars in England, with England. They were continuously having wars, and the wars were there in different parts of the world, not only in Europe. They shared the boundaries. France and England, they shared the boundaries, but they were fighting in whole world. Wherever the British go, French also is there. Wherever the French go, British also is there. So they were having wars in different parts of the world. So the France need to have a lot of army. And because of that, their expenses increased a lot. And you can see how much army they required. France at that time had 13 American colonies to get freedom. What France did? They had 13 American colonies to get freedom from Britain. In that case, we can understand how much the country has to bear. और ये सब जो हो रहा था, because of all these wars, they have 1 billion beavers dead, more than 1 million beavers. Beavers was the currency of the country at that time. This much debt they were having, and it rose to 2 billion livres in a very few time. Now the king has to get credit from the money lenders, and in the interest he had to oblige them, because the king was not having much money and he was taking money from the money lenders, so he has to oblige money lenders. And because they were not having any kind of money, they had to meet the requirement of budget, the army, the court, to run the government offices, everywhere they need money. So in this condition, the France was in a situation where their resources were completely drained up, and they have to find some ways to earn money. What King Duke done? He imposed taxes. He imposed heavy taxes, so that the state get a lot of money, and the debt which has to be paid to the money lenders can be paid. Now the second problem arises. It was there with the taxes. For that, we need to understand the situation of French society. How was the French society during that period? The society was divided into three estates. The first estate, that was clergy. Who was the part of clergy? The person who attached with the church. They were the part of clergy. The second part, nobility. Whosoever is attached by the royal court are the part of nobility. And then comes the third estate. The third estate has three parts. In first one, businessmen, merchants and officers. In the second category, peasants and artisans. And in third category, small peasants, landed laborers and the servants. How problem arises? It was in the way that the clergy and the nobility has to pay no taxes, because the people who were the part of clergy were serving the church, so they need not to pay taxes. The second part, nobility, they are the administrators, so they need not to pay taxes. So all the burden was there on the third category, third estate. They had to pay all the taxes. Now in the third estate there were three categories. First one is of businessmen, merchants and officers. They were also attached with the royal court. Many businessmen had given loan to the king, so they were also obliged. Now the burden was there on the peasants, artisans, landed laborers and on the servants. It means the third estate, the lowest part of the society, was facing the highest burden. These people, they had a very few land, very lesser land to arrange their livelihood. Most of the land were under the ownership of church. And in the remaining land, a very large part was there with the big peasants who were paying very less taxes. And the other small farmers, they have a very low level of land, very less number of land, and they have to pay a lot of taxes. Now if the third estate has to pay taxes only to the government, then it can be understood, okay, they can pay. But there were two types of tax. The church to extract its share of taxes called tithes from the peasant, and then the direct tax, that is tithes, that was collected by the king from the peasants, from the artisans and from the small businessmen. So, what they face exactly, that the most of the part of society was the whom were owing all the resources, they need not to pay taxes, and the part of society which is struggling with their livelihood, they have to pay all the taxes. So it became a burden to the society. Now what to do with the society?
society was struggling for the survival. That we understand in the next video.